I'm going to turn it over to Coach Gord. Coach Gord is the director of baseball operations at NCSA out of Chicago. It's the largest recruiting basically company in the world. They do every sport. They work with basically 1,600 colleges across the country. Anything from player profiles that would auto-populate into our coach packet, to editing video, to all that kind of stuff. But Nelson's probably the most knowledgeable person I've ever met in terms of knowing recruiting information. If you have any questions at all, this would be the guy to talk to. Especially with a lot of the rule changes with the NCAA, or the NCAA and all that kind of stuff. He's up to date on all that as well. So, Coach Gord, I'll turn it over to you.
Somebody who believes in you guys, who believes in your family, and basically play the next level. Okay, sometimes that's not always because of athletic ability, oftentimes that's because of the passion that you guys exhibit, the energy that you show, that you really want to do. Okay, and that says a lot about you guys' families, you guys' players, as to why you're out here. So I have two choices, and I'll leave this up to you guys. Do you want the easy way, or do you want the truth? What do you want, the easy way or the truth? Okay, so I'm going to lay this out there. This may ruffle some feathers, may strike a chord with some people, but I really believe that the reason that you're out here is for these next 10 minutes. Okay, this showcase event, any showcase event, any game, any training session, anything that you do on a field, okay, is fleeting. Whether you go 0-4 or 4-4, that day comes and goes, and there's nothing you can do to change it, right? Okay, what we're talking about here is something that goes well beyond that. Okay, when we're talking about recruiting, we're not just talking about what happens in the next couple years of teaching college. We're not talking about the 3, 4, 5 years you might be in school. Okay, you're talking about what sets the stage for the rest of your life. Okay, where you go to school influences, in many cases, your first job. Okay, it might be the person that you end up marrying, who the best man at your wedding is. God, father of your children. Okay, what you do in those years at school, okay, or after high school, dictate a lot of the future. Okay, so that's why it's interesting to me when many people, they spend as little time as they do actually digging into the process. Okay, and that's what really, really shocks me. The sheets that you have there in front of you, everybody there can read. You know, I'm not going to sit there and go through it verbatim. But I am going to hit on a few high points. I'm going to touch on a few things and make sure that we fully understand what it takes to get to the next level, whatever that might be. Okay. In addition to you know, just my recruiting background and all that, you know, recently I started doing scouting work for the New York Yankees. Okay, so that's just another thing that I do in addition to everything else. It's kind of hard to speak to the background. I want to start just busting an opportunity. But on that sheet, there's 5 things listed. Okay, and if you run down the list, the first one is, when does the recruiting process start? Okay, very simply put, it started yesterday. Okay, I know we got some guys that are just going into their freshman year in high school. We have other players here that are rising seniors. So there's a big spectrum of a wide range of people to work with. Okay, but there's nothing that you can do to get back to what happened yesterday. All the recruiters look forward. And the best analogy that I oftentimes use is, when you look at recruiting, it's really no different than having a best friend, okay, than asking a girl to the prom or homecoming dance. Okay, it's not something that happens by chance. It's not something where you bump into somebody in the hallway and suddenly, hey, you want to be my best friend? Hey, you want to go to the dance with me? It doesn't work out that way. Okay, you develop a relationship over time. You find common ground, you find common interests. Okay, you want to be around that person. And as much as college coaches, they want somebody that is a great athlete, solid student, you know, is a good person in the community, they want a person. that's not something that shows up on paper. Okay, that's something they have to spend time with you. They have to get to know you. They have to get to know the person. They have to get to know the family. Where's the boy come from? Okay, and that's why, you know, I'm not advocating or saying that, hey, you need to commit to some school early. I'm sure many of the coaches that even go through that, you know, don't necessarily agree with it, but it's more or less their dotted line. What I am saying is that you have to be proactive. Okay, we have some colleges out here today. There's a number of them out there. If you're not willing to pick up the phone, if you're not willing to send out an email and introduce yourself, if you're not willing to go to a camp and say, hey, coach, I'm interested in your program, okay, then you're not going to go and have a test run. You're not going to take that a couple of things. You're not going to end up at that school. Okay, you guys have to develop relationships. What you're going to find out is that oftentimes the big picture, the dream school, you know, that you have as a little kid or as a junior high kid or even your freshman, sophomore in high school, be the best school for you. Maybe it is, okay, but oftentimes you find a place that you might have never even heard of that has what you need socially, academically, athletically to meet your needs, okay, to make things happen. Does that make sense to everybody? Okay, the second thing on there is, you know, understand that college coaches, they're limited in both time and financial resources. Okay, they can't be everywhere at once. They can't go coast to coast, north to south, and everything in between on any given day and drop a hat. Okay, they go places because they have lists of kids. They have players that they're interested in, and they're going to attend different events, different tournaments, different games to see and follow that player. Okay, so the important thing is to get on those lists some way, somehow. In some cases, that's going to the school's website, filling out their questionnaire. Other times, it's getting into programs. Like Crossroads, you know, we utilize the coach packet, you know, give that information to the coaches. There's a variety of different ways to do it, but if there's an opportunity to get into a list where college coaches can see you, take advantage of that. Okay, and that doesn't mean that you have to spend an enormous amount of money to make that happen, but it does mean if there are free resources and an opportunity to do that, then by all means, put your name in there, update your information, make sure that they can contact you, because that's what it'll come for. Okay, the third piece, and I'll turn this open mic here in a second, but the third piece is, when I was going through the recruiting process, and I wanted to get myself in front of a college coach, I would have to take a VHS tape. You guys know what that is. You've seen it, right? They're probably like hidden in your basement somewhere, like behind like the old TV in the corner, all the rest of the store stuff, right? So I had to take a VHS tape, and I took my grandma's and hooked it up to mine, my parents. I had to keep recording, and I had to take bubble wrap, and I had to send it out to schools, and it took forever. I pretty much had no social life. One, it's not very cool. But two, because I was sitting there recording videos and trying to send them out. Okay, you guys don't have to do that anymore. Okay, between the devices that you have in your pocket, and guys like Skillshow, who's here today, video is so accessible. Okay, it's so cool, it's so easy to distribute. So I'll let Mike talk a little bit about Skillshow here and more about that.
Hey guys, my name's Mike with Skillshow. I know I've spoken to some of you guys that have done or through email the past weekend. But just to explain a little bit of what Skillshow is, what we're doing here at Crossroads is Eric got us involved this year and putting together clips for everybody at the showcase today. So going home today, everyone's going to get a clip of them playing their position, field, hitting, or pitching, your pitcher. Everyone's going to get something that's going to get put up on Coach's packet. For all those coaches that have access, they'll be able to see some type of video, which is so important in the recruiting process. College coaches, they really do see video, especially when you're first contacting a college coach. Send them your video. That way they can actually see who you are. They can evaluate them, you for themselves, and they can really just get a mental picture of who you are as a player. What we're doing today and what we've already done is we filmed you guys running your 60, and we got 2 minutes of you hitting your batting practice. For the rest of the day, position players, we're going to have 2 cameras on you. One camera tracking throws, tracking your throws, and one camera that's just a close-up to see your athleticism and movement. What we do is we provide Crossroads and Coach's packet with that close-up angle, unedited, so everyone gets a video. We do offer the upgraded option, which information down here in this corner. We also have information on how to choose a college. That has helped a lot of parents and families and players kind of narrow down your college search. So feel free to come on down and grab some papers. I'll pass them out as well. I'll pass this over back over to Nelson. And thank you.
Thank you. How many of you guys watched that on the chat? A lot of the videos that you saw when they're promoting players, you're going over the player recaps, were shot by the fans. Okay, some of the best in the world, you know, so many draft picks, it's an endless amount, you know, were shot by Skillshare. So it's pretty amazing to think that, you know, out of all the places in the world, they could be there right here with you guys today. Okay, that's amazing with Crossroads and Bias and Aspect, and you know, you guys, who knows, your video might be in a file right next to like Hunter Green or something like that. But very, very cool. Last two things on that sheet, and then we'll get you going with the rest of the infield, outfield, and gameplay. Number four, okay, where are you qualified to play? And as a, you know, I was the head varsity high school coach, running a travel program, probably the toughest conversation kind of to have with the players, but more so with the parents. You know, because let's face it, you guys are spending a tremendous amount of resources, both time and financial, to help your son pursue their dreams. And oftentimes we get confused with what is actually important. And we say, well, you know, it's that D1, you know, high profile scholarship or bust. You know, if we don't get that, then what's this all really worth? Okay, and I think when you go through the process and you get beyond the process, most come to realize that it's not necessarily about that, okay, but it's about how good of an experience they have, and that day when you drop your son off in college, that he's in the absolute right place. Okay, and last spring there were over 1,643 schools that played college baseball. If I gave you guys a pen and paper right now, anybody here, I would be shocked. I'd be blown away if you could write down more than 100. I'd probably give you an A-plus if you write down more than 50. Okay, and I would guess that most would be at 40. 30 to 40 range of schools that they can actually name off the top of their data plan. Okay, so to think that there are over 1,600 more than you can actually write on a piece of paper is amazing. That's 53,000 roster spots. That's 11% of all high school players will have the opportunity to go on to play.